Hello everyone, welcome to this video on the future of this channel. First and foremost, I want to say the channel is not going anywhere. We are still going to be here for a little while to come, but I'll get more into that future into the later part of this video. This music is the relaxing music compilation by TerraShock. The link to the video is on the screen, so make sure you go check that out. Support a really great piece of music. In this video, I'm just going to be talking about the future of the channel, so if you do feel like tabbing out and going to do something else, maybe working on something while listening to this, feel free to do so, as there will be nothing popping up on the screen except for the end page, as usual. So the future of the channel is going to be easily analyzed by looking through the past. So something I need to talk about, and might have been the end of the channel, happened about the beginning of September, October, around that time, in the fall. I had just finished the year one of my favorite moments, my top 10 favorite moments of the channel in the past first year of the channel, but after that, I sort of hit a downward spiral. I did not know what to make videos on. I was running out of ideas. I was unmotivated to do any videos. And I put out very little content. I think maybe a video per week. And that wasn't a whole lot for me. And getting into October, November, around that time, the end of fall, I began thinking about just shutting the channel down in general. I almost quit YouTube. So I actually prepared to do this video in the fall, around beginning of November, saying, hey guys, it's been fun, we've had a good year, I'm not going to continue going on. But I was talking to one of my real life friends, and I was saying, hey, I do this thing on YouTube, and he's like, dude, that's really cool. You really should keep it up because you really enjoyed it. You really have enjoyed doing it, and you've put a lot of work and effort into it, so there's no point in giving it up now. But my whole thing is looking farther down the road. I'm not going to do this for a career. I know that. It's not what I want to do as a career. It's fun to do. It's a great hobby, but it's not making me any money. It won't make me any money to live on, and honestly, that's what I need to be looking at. I don't know how I'm going to provide for myself if I'm not making money off of YouTube, and that's my job. And I really don't want to do another fast food job or another job in retail, so finding a real job that's not YouTube is my path to go. Now, I'm going to be doing YouTube for a while as a hobby. It might become a side project, it might become another job in the future, another side job. But for now, it's staying around, and I'm not going to change a whole lot of what's coming out in these videos. And the future of the channel is looking pretty good right now. I do have to say that a few things I wanted to build on in the next year would be continue doing some best team videos. I want to continue doing my live streams that I've started doing. But live streams are really hard for me to do. I like to do them when I'm the only one in the house, and that rarely happens. As you can see, I've only done about two. So I want to continue that, and I also want to get some equipment to do it. However, that costs money, and it's a struggle for me to put money into YouTube because I look at it and say, I'm putting money into it, I'm not going to get any profit out of it. I get enjoyment out of it, and honestly, that's why we play video games, but I'm not sure if I want to do that yet. So that's a struggle right now for me. Maybe if I start monetizing videos, I will definitely start putting stuff into this, like getting a capture card so I can play 3DS games and not have the setup I do where I have to take my laptop and record the video. I really would like to do some of that stuff. And if I made this a living, made some money off of it, I definitely would spend a whole lot more time with editing and stuff, getting some more high-quality editing software so I can do more stuff with the videos, make them look more clean, and ultimately make them a good YouTube video for you guys to watch. My quality right now is not where I want it to be at. It's better than it was the first year. But there are many things we can still do. One of the things I'm working on for the new year is getting some new channel art, getting some new channel profiles. So I'm actually going to have a profile that's not the Mega Charizards swirling, and you're not going to see these slide backgrounds. Because we're going to have a new slide background, we're going to have new stuff going into the video, and more editing will be coming through that, because I would want to make it look more clean. So I've actually got a friend to do some art for me, and when I get that, that's going to be starting on the channel. You're going to see the top 10s, not in the Sonic background, or the Charizard background, or the Link background. They're going to be in that one background to solidify the channel as one and not like three separate entities. And that's another thing we did this year. We split the channel into more than just Pokemon, and I've been wanting to do that since I started. I'll talk about why I began YouTube in another video, so make sure you stick around for that. But Pokemon was my start, and I always enjoyed playing Sonic, Legend of Zelda, Mario, most Nintendo franchises, some Call of Duty, some shooters, some this and that, a little bit of everything, really. And making a YouTube channel, you really can't focus on more than one aspect and succeed very well unless people really like you as a content creator. And usually people don't know you as a content creator unless you're around for at least a couple years. Most people don't start getting a bunch of subs until they're at least 2 or 3 years old as a channel. So only being about a year and a half right now, and already branching out, it's kind of scary for me, just because I know sitting at under 100 subscribers, it's kind of hard for me to branch out, because I have 30 people, and if those 30 people sub for Pokemon videos, and no one has subbed for my Legend of Zelda videos, or Sonic videos, then all those videos that have come out are not good quality for them. They're not going to watch my videos, they're not going to stay on my channel, they're going to leave, and I'm going to lose subscribers. So getting a bigger fan base is definitely something that's going to help. It's going to make the channel so much better. It's going to give me freedom to do more things that I want to do, and not make it feel like sometimes that I have to do YouTube, I have to do a Pokemon video here and there. Because honestly, sometimes I get done with Pokemon, and I probably wouldn't be doing YouTube at all if I didn't get back into Pokemon. I sort of played it casually, like, oh yeah, cool, play through it once, and I'm done. Never have to play the game again. But now, looking through it and doing analytics on it, running analytics, playing through the game with different aspects, different variants on it, it's a lot more fun, and I've really enjoyed coming back to Pokemon. And again, I'm getting into the other video, but I will stop for that conversation for now. We'll continue that in a different video. Make sure you go watch that when it comes out. It should be out probably about the same day as this. But really what I want to focus on is what can you expect in the new year. Well, you're going to expect some more branching out stuff. You're going to see some more Sonic. You're going to see some more Legend of Zelda. You're going to see some more Pokemon. And honestly, have a bunch of discussion videos ready to come out. Ideas in my head. I have theories that I've been holding on to. Top 5s, top 10s. Best teams are going to come back and be better than ever. I'm still working on those, but as I'm still playing through Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon, that's still going to take a little bit of time. So you'll probably see those more coming out in the spring as I finish my Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon stuff and start working on the older games and playing through those again. I hope to do a lot more top 10s and top 5s coming out on all three topics. It's a lot of fun for me to rank my things in certain orders. I'm debating doing some review videos that might be shown on the channel in the future year. So get ready for those to come out as well as you can see some various projects coming here and there, I definitely plan on doing some more co-ops. I know Damien and I just finished the Ruby and Sapphire Versus. They're already planning stuff for the next co-op, so that should be coming out hopefully sometime in the early part of this year. It might take a little bit longer though, so don't hold me to that. You're going to see some more content like Doki Doki Literature Club. It's just a few games here and there that I find that I want to play, and what better way to showcase them than to put them on the channel and play them. And Doki Doki Literature Club is actually a really fun game, and I'm really enjoying myself playing through it. So definitely come out and watch those videos. There is a new video today because this will be posted on New Year's, and the video will be out at 1 o'clock, so make sure you stay around for that. It's my favorite episode as of now. I really had a fun time recording that one, so make sure you go check that one out. And a huge thing that's coming out is we're doing another draft league, and I'm actually running this one. It is the Fletchling Tube Fikes League. We do it through the Fletchling Tube Facebook page that I have mentioned in a couple videos. But me and three other YouTubers are joining fray to battle each other with drafted teams through Smogon's Pokemon Showdown. So that'll be coming out sometime in the next year. We've already done the draft, and we're ready to start the league. We just get to get a few things ironed out here and there, and we'll be ready to go. But ultimately, I think this year is going to be a good year for the channel. I hope it is. I would like to get a good follow base, a good subscriber base, and I definitely would like to see a view on at least all my videos throughout this year. I know people don't have time sometimes to watch videos, and I'm not saying that's a bad thing, but I'm not finding myself watching videos from 3 years ago here and there just to look at them, and oftentimes I'll like them because they're actually good videos, and I really like seeing how people have grown. So if these videos don't get liked for a couple years, that's okay, but a lot of the reason I want to see these views and I want to see these likes and I want to see subscriber boost are because it makes me feel better about doing this stuff. Because just doing YouTube and doing the videos, anybody can do that. And then sharing that with people, and then nobody wants to watch it, it kind of is a little bit disheartening. So it's kind of a struggle here and there. But seeing you guys come out, even if it's for just my best team videos, even if it's just for my Pokemon teams videos, even if it's just for my theory videos, I don't care. You guys come out, you guys come and watch these videos, and that's why I continue to do it. And that was part of the reason why I didn't quit in November. So this video has really adapted for me. It's been in the process in my mind for about half a year now. And seeing how this evolved into a future video and not the end of the channel is really, really great. And I'm really happy that I continue to stick around. And I hope you guys are happy too. So I think that's what I'm going to leave this video. Thank you so much for watching. And if you are excited about the future of this channel, make sure you go ahead and leave a like. And also subscribe to stay up to date on the latest videos coming out from ChaosMay 006. If you're not already following me on Twitter and Instagram, go do that at ChaosMay 006. Really excited to see how you guys are doing out there. And speaking of Twitter, we have a question that came in. I asked you guys 4 questions for this video. And I have a question from my friend Damien Dragon, who I've mentioned in this video already. He asked me, what kind of setup do you use for your videos? Now that really depends on the video I'm running. It's the top 5, top 10, I usually use, my OBS is my recording software, so I use OBS, and I'll go on YouTube, find a clip of music, and put that underneath. And that'll be just that video. It's not a whole lot of editing process. I do make the slides and stuff on the back, taking pictures from here and there, throwing them in, trying to do the best with those. If it's gameplay content, usually I'll make a layout with GIF, and I'll put those in here and there. Usually you've seen those in my Nuzlocke where I have teams and I update it all. That's a lot of work to do. Some other videos where I have to take pieces of other videos and put them in, like my recent Legend of Zelda Triforce Theory video, I had to do a bunch of editing in video. I had to edit in a whole video into my own video, so that takes some time. And doing that, I usually run that through Lightworks, which is a free platform. It can be paid for and you get some bonuses to it, but honestly, the free version works just fine. And what else can I think of? I don't really use anything else, so I use GIF, Lightworks, and OBS are my editing and video making processes. And occasionally here and there, I will use YouTube editing stuff at the end once you post the video, but usually I've stayed away from that because I wanted something different. But I thank you very much, Damien, for asking that question, and I hope that gives you a good idea of what goes into these videos. So again, thank you so much for watching all the way through this video, and that's all I have for you today. Hopefully I see you in the future. But for now, I am ChaosMay006, signing off. Burn it up.